appears as though something has happened in the motorcade route. Something, I repeat, has happened in the motorcade route.
I was in the follow-up car on the left running board. And I had, as we turned down Elm Street in Dallas from Houston, the crowds had kind of dropped off. There weren't that many people on either side of the street. Some, but not many. And I was scanning to my left, the crowd that was there, and straight ahead of the motorcade, which was going to go under an underpass. And there were some people on top of it, and I was concerned, but I saw some police up there. And then all of a sudden, I heard this explosive noise over my right shoulder. Came from the rear and over my right shoulder, and I started to turn toward the noise. But I only got as far as the president's car. And I saw what happened in the car. I saw the president, he grabbed at his throat and he moved to his left, and I knew something was wrong. So I jumped off my position from the follow-up car and ran toward the presidential car with the intention of getting up on top of the back of it to form a shield up on the top of the back of the car so that no further damage could be done to either President or Mrs. Kennedy. Now, they told me that there was another shot while I was running. I didn't hear it because when I jumped off the car, there was a motorcycle officer just to my left, and I had to run between the motorcycle officer and the follow-up car to get to the president's car. But then just as I reached, just about got to the president's car, there was a third shot. Now, the president had turned when after he got hit the first time, got hit in the back of the neck, just below the neckline, just to the right of the spinal column, it came out the throat. When that happened, he couldn't fall to his right because the car was right up, the side of the car was right beside him, and he couldn't fall forward or duck because he had a back brace on. So he had to go to his left. He went to his left, and his head kind of went down. So when that third shot hit, it hit the back of his head here and exploded out the upper right rear quadrant of the skull. And it was blood and bone fragments and brain, all that material out on the trunk on me and on Mrs. Kennedy. Just as I got to the car, started up on the car, she came up on the trunk. And she was grabbing at that material, trying to gather it together, that she didn't know I was there. And I finally got a hold of her and put her in the back seat. And then the president's body fell to its left with his head in her lap, and his right side of his face was up. I could see his eyes were fixed, and I could see through the hole in the skull that there was almost no brain matter left in that area. And I thought it was a fatal wound. Well, she was in shock immediately because of what happened. But she did say a couple things. She said, I have his brains in my hand. And then she said, oh, Jack, Jack, what have they done? I love you, Jack. And that's really all she said in the car. Well, I had no idea what was happening other than the fact that someone was shooting at the president, and that whether it was a group or an individual, I had no idea. All I knew was somebody was shooting, and I was going to do what I could to cover him up so that we could get out of there. We were tasked with the responsibility of protecting the president and the members of the first family. And on this particular day, we failed. We didn't do it. And so that's bothered me ever since. You know, what if it had rained that morning? What if a lot of things? So, and what if I'd have been able to move a little faster? I wouldn't be here, but President Kennedy would probably be alive.